And that is the secret in improving your 5K time. Parkruns are weekly timed 5K events that take place every Saturday morning at 9 o'clock. Parkrun first began in 2004 in Bushey Park, London, and now spans to 1,709 parkruns worldwide. With the total number of registered parkrunners quickly approaching 200,000, today I share my tips on how to run a faster parkrun. So my first tip is to improve your training regime. Now there's no secret that to improve your 5K time, just like any other race distance, you need to see an improvement in your training. Now there are a number of ways in which you can do this. The first is to increase the volume of running you do per week. So you can do this by running more miles, maybe increasing the frequency of your runs. So for example, if you're currently running twice a week, try adding a third run into your training plan. Another way you can improve your training regime is with intensity. A really good way to do this when you're a beginner runner is to add in some simple but effective speed sessions into your training. I'd recommend trying one of these training sessions per week if you're somebody who's not got currently any interval type training in their plans. The first session is 10 by 400 meters with 1 minute standing recoveries. Now these 400 meter reps, you want to be running at just faster than your 5K pace. And then for that 1 minute 30, you stand and try and recover and get ready to do that again. Another great session to try is 4 by 1 kilometer. Now these kilometer reps, try and hit your target 5K pace for these, and the rest for this workout is 2 minutes. As you get faster and fitter, I suggest increasing the number of reps and reducing that recovery time, but sticking to these workouts. So for example, a workout that I now do as a 15 minute 5K runner is 20 by 400 meters at slightly faster than my 5K pace. So I've just increased the number of reps and I now do 45 seconds recovery. So I've reduced the amount of time I get to recover. So with these sessions, adapt them to your current fitness, your current ability, and as time goes on, you can gradually adapt them to make them a little bit more challenging. Another way you can improve your training regime is to obtain a weekly structure that you can consistently hit each week. So for me, when I started, I used to have Tuesdays off work, and I knew that Tuesday was going to be my speed session every week because I could sort of handle a slightly higher volume and intensity of training on that day. So for you, it may be on Saturdays, you've got a window that you can then do your long run. So just putting in place a weekly structure that you can constantly go back to and maintain over weeks of training really, really helps when building and improving your training, which hopefully will lead to an improvement in your 5K time. And the final few points to make about improving your training regime is to try and follow the 80-20 rule. Now this basically means 80% of your training should be easy running. Now these are runs where you go out, conversational pace, you're not putting too much strain on your body, and these should form 80% of your training. The rest, 20%, are those speed sessions, the slightly higher intensity workouts. And these are sort of like the cherry on top of your training. They build that speed and they get you ready for race day. Now, with improving your training, I will just say, any improvements you make need to be gradual. So for me, when I looked at increasing my volume, I followed a 10% rule each week. So for example, if I ran 30 kilometers in week one, in week two of my training block, I increased that to 33 kilometers and so on. And that basically was a good amount to increase each week, allowed my body to adapt to the new training stimulus and basically continue progressing through my training without any risk of injury. So tip number two is don't try and run a faster parkrun every single week. Now I was a sucker for this when I started my parkrun journey, if you like. I think I ran maybe 6 consecutive PBs week after week after week, which at the time was incredible. But this actually isn't a great way to train to run a faster 5K. A race effort can actually cause a lot of fatigue on the body, which can be detrimental to your training. So for example, if you try and bash out a 5K PB every Saturday morning at parkrun, the rest of the week you may spend recovering, and not being able to do those training runs means eventually you will plateau in your 5K progression. So my advice, if you're serious about seeing an improvement in your 5K time, would be to pick a parkrun every month, one or two, I would say as a maximum, to treat as your A race. So one parkrun a month, you go all out, you give it your all, you see if you can beat your PB, and for the remaining three, you just treat them as training runs. So for example, 1 week, you might wanna just do them as an easy run, Another week you might want to put in a little bit more effort, so say a tempo effort at around 60-70%. But yeah, I'd recommend one effort a month. It allows you to build your training up, and it prevents fatigue and plateauing in your 5k time. Tip number three is to pick a faster course. Now in the UK, we are lucky enough to have 714 park runs across the country. Some of these are completely flat, some of these are completely hilly, some are even on sand, like the Great Yarmouth Park Run. Nobody's ever broken 20 minutes there, and it is definitely on my list, so I'll see you soon, Great Yarmouth Park Run. The terrain in which you run your 5k park run can make a big, big difference on your time. So my advice would be, do a little bit of park run tourism, visit some of the fastest park runs in the country. Ones to know are Victoria Dock Park Run in London. One of my personal favourites is Eaton Park Run in Norwich, and another new one that started up recently is Chalkwell Beach Park Run, which is an out and back along the coast down in Southend. So yeah, give a different park run a go, and that can maybe take one, even 2 minutes off your park run time, just dependent on the terrain in which you're running on. And that brings me on to my fourth and final tip in today's video, and that is, don't be afraid to run further than your race distance in training. So it's a common misconception that if you're training to improve your 5k time, you don't need to run further than 5k in your training. Longer runs actually can really, really help improve your aerobic capacity. Now, 5k running is 90% aerobic and 10% anaerobic. So it's only that last sort of 100 meter sprint that you really need the speed to go above your lactate threshold and push your body to the limits. The rest of it should all be fairly controlled in that aerobic zone. Now, to improve your aerobic capacity, one of the best ways you can do this is by doing long runs. Now, when you're starting off in your 5k training, you might want to try and work towards a 45 minute long run and slowly, gradually build that up to around the hour and 30 minute mark. Now, in 5k training, that can mean running anything from 8 kilometers all the way up to 20 kilometers in your 5k training for your long run period. These runs, I would recommend doing these at an easy pace, so in that zone 2 conversational pace, and these runs can really, really help improve your aerobic capacity, which then when you reduce the distance down again to the 5k, you can really see an improvement in your speed. So there we go. 4 tips today to improve your park run. I hope you found them interesting and that you can start implementing into your training. I will say, as I said earlier, any changes you make to your training plans, you need to do them gradually. If you do them too quickly, you can result in injury, which can then be detrimental to your training. So it's all about learning what your body can take, slowly adapting your training regime over the weeks, and building up the consistency month after month after month. And that is the secret in improving your 5k time. If you're completely new to the channel, please consider subscribing for more running related videos. And if you're a current subscriber, please drop a like, comment down below. It really helps with the YouTube algorithm, and maybe consider sharing this video with a friend or maybe your local parkrun group chat. Thank you very much for watching again. Aspire to run, run to inspire, and we'll see you again with another video soon. Bye-bye.